Hi, everybody.
East Coast Pete here with my show, Lest We Forget. Lest We Forget OPETH. They are Swedish prog metal from Stockholm in 1989. The band had a high turnover, replacing every original member. Lead vocalist, guitarist, and songwriter Michael Åkerfeldt has been the driving force since the departure of vocalist David Iceberg in 92. This is a mix of prog, folk, blues, classical, and jazz, with more than a smattering of death metal. There are clean vocals and also death growls, but Åkerfeldt growls are not as harsh as some. The death growl is an extended vocal technique used in death metal and metalcore. The lyrics are often obscene but unintelligible. Death metal is considered darker than other metal styles, sometimes deep, sometimes high and screechy. The intent is to invoke demonic beasts. Just 'cause, you know, Vikings. Even real ones did it in the 10th century. Oh, and the devil doesn't sing melodically, so it's all Screaming Jay Hawkins' fault with his I Put a Spell on You in 1956. Greg Lake can also be held accountable for 21st Century Schizoid Man by King Crimson, Iron Man by Black Sabbath, and One of These Days by Pink Floyd contain brief passages of ominous growled words. I am Iron Man, and One of These Days I'm going to cut you into little pieces, respectively. Cam Lee was with Death, and Chuck Schuldiner have been cited as the first metal vocalist to do it. Since then, the technique has spread like the plague, and like rap, the use of growls isn't going away anytime soon. OPETH is notable because they are only part-time growlers. Mellotrons also are featured on OPETH's albums. For their first four albums, OPETH rarely played live, but with the release of Blackwater Park in 2001, they have made several world tours. There have been 13 studio albums so far, 4 live DVDs, and 2 box sets. The first OPETH album to leave a mark on the United States consciousness was their 8th album, Ghost Reveries, and major American success came with Watershed in 2008. It reached 23 on the Billboard 200, and it is mesmerizing. OPETH's name was taken from the Wilbur Smith novel, The Sunbird. OPETH is the name of a fictional Phoenician city in South Africa, translated at City of the Moon. David Iceberg left, citing creative differences. When Åkerfeldt took the helm, the band would rely less on blast beats and add passages of acoustic guitar harmonies to their sound, which became their core sound. Orchid was the debut LP in 94 on Candlelight Records. This was a new label, and a metal band with clean vocals and acoustic guitars was experimental. It would take time to develop a fan base that could accept the new sound. Their second LP, Morning Rise, attracted the attention of Century Media Records, who signed the band and released the first two albums in the U.S. in 1997. And their third album, My Arms, Your Hearse, was released to critical acclaim in 1998. Still Life, a concept album, was next. The story's about a heretic ousted from his homeland, but later returns to be with his lady. The elders are not overjoyed and cause problems for the couple. Their conversations are the parts in the lyrics. Can only imagine what that might be. Why did you come back? I wanted to be with you. You shouldn't be here. I know. You know, stuff like that, maybe. Stephen Wilson produced their fifth album, Blackwater Park. Death metal would never be the same. Of course it would. Next, Ackerfeld. Felt conflicted. He wanted to make an album that would be the heaviest yet, but he had a backlog of light acoustic and mellow parts done. So Jonas Rensky of Catatonia suggested he make two albums, one heavy and one light. Ackerfeld had to convince them that the expense of two albums would be no more than the outlay for one, since the band would record them simultaneously, and this proved to be a tough job. Deliverance was released first, but aspects of it were rushed. Still, it went to number 19 in the U.S. The second album, Damnation, was also rushed. Both albums were rushed, taking only 7 weeks in the studio. Deliverance was the heavy album, and Damnation was the mellow album, which is brilliant. The two albums were re-released as a set. Tours began and took up the next 2 years. And then Watershed was their highest charting album to date. It was also their last to contain death growls. Okay. Here's the songs. One, Coil. Melodious Melancholy. Two, Heir Apparent. Is it the king or the heir with the growls? I don't know. Three, The Lotus Eater. Heaviosity. Many Layers. It's like a wall of sound. Four, Burden. It's a ballad. There's a notion of sorrow. Sorrow in you. Five, Porcelain Heart. Porcel, and I'd sure like to see OPETH live. Melantropic. And six, Hessian Peel. So many parts to each song. Vocal harmonies, Mellotronia. And seven, Hex Omega. On the special edition, there's also Derelict Herds. Do Cipollina. Do Cobra. Nine, Bridge of Sighs by Robin Trower. Spot on. Do Harvey Mandel. 10, Den Standiga Reson, which is Marie Fredriksson. The next album, Heritage, was all prog, all clean. Maybe they ran out of Hall's Mentholyptus. Heritage was called OPETH's most adventurous album. The tours were that of rock superstars as complex as a full circus taken on the road. OPETH was no longer a bunch of guys getting together to play the music they loved. There was no turning back. In 2014 saw Pale Communion, OPETH's 11th studio album, and it debuted at number 19 in the U.S. It is certainly grand. In 2016 saw Sorceress. OPETH won Best Video of the Year and Best Band of the Year internationally. Åkerfeldt thought to try something twisted. This would be In Cauda Venenum in 2019. Åkerfeldt said Judas Priest's Sad Wings of Destiny in 76 was the best album of all time. He said there was a time when he was young and only listened to Priest. It was only later that he discovered Prog and Folk, both of which had a profound impact on the sound of OPETH. Here's a list of bands who cite OPETH as an influence: Mayan, Gorguts, Sohn, Leprous, Dissolution, Caligula's Horse, Klimt 1918, Ahab, Becoming the Archetype, Nucleus Torn, Q-Han, Wastefall, The Contortionist, Thomas McLean, and Tomera, The Man-Eating Tree, Night Area, District Unknown, Nehemiah, Obimai, Dos Chu, Schizoid Lloyd, Native Construct, Catalocus, Bilocate, Seven Lions, John Petrucci, Mike Portnoy, and Isan, Epica, Camelot, Fate's Warning, and Haken. OPETH Heritage A+. Here's the songs. One, Heritage. It's got a piano intro and the bass sneaks in mysteriously. Two, The Devil's Orchard. This is the full band. Three, I Feel the Dark, Prog Mantra. Four, Slither, A Snake in a Hurry. Five, Nepenthe, Calm but Not for Long. Spooky song, like John McLaughlin in parts. Six, Hake's Process, very subdued. Whoa, who invited Bert Jansch? Seven, Famine, deep in the savannah, an oasis stripped bare, a caravan of death. Eight, The Lines in My Hand, what a bass line. Whew. Hokey smokes, Bullwinkle. 9, Folklore. No Whoop Helvin, more Stone Barrow. Stonehenge Jazz, I think I meant to say Wood Helvin. 10, Marrow of the Earth. Stone and Sea, Pitchwife. Yeah, OPETH's very high on East Coast Pete's list now. I can't wait to go see them. Hope they come around. And I hope you can stay around with me, because my next band is going to be... I don't know. Let's check and see. And get to hear a little more of OPETH while I turn the pages to find the next band. Oh, next up, Magma. Wow, they are really weird. Can't wait. See you next time. Bye-bye.